Survey warned that Tuesday's earthquake in Christchurch could turn out to be the country's single most tragic event. And the claim of car insurance premiums could rise for everyone if the European Court of Justice found insurance companies using gender as a factor when they set premiums. The United States has imposed sanctions on Libya while the United Nations considers further action in response to the bloodshed in the country. A son of Libyan leader Colonel Gaddafi has said his forces are trying to negotiate a ceasefire with rebels. Our first editor Jeremy Bowen has been allowed into Tripoli under official escort and sent this report.
Colonel Gaddafi's speeches, there was another one yesterday, are as defiant as ever, but his son, Sirhan Islam, is directing more conciliatory statements to foreign reporters who've now been allowed into Tripoli. In a news conference, he said peace was coming back to Libya. He denied the Libyan Air Force full army responsibility and blamed equal black forces for the trouble in the country. But the BBC has received videos and reports from people in Tripoli who say they witnessed forces loyal to Colonel Gaddafi shooting at civilians.
Just thought up to 500 Britons are still in Libya, most working in the desert interior at oil fields. Overnight, a Royal Navy frigate arrived in Malta carrying more than 200 evacuees from Libya, including 60 British nationals. HMS Cumberland left the port of Benghazi on Thursday. From Malta, here's Gavin Hewitt. The final British government charter flight will leave Tripoli Airport this morning. It's obliged to get to the airport in first flight. The focus now is on the more than 170 British citizens who are in remote and possibly vulnerable desert locations. The government says a lot of work is now underway to extract them. Some British forces have arrived in Malta. Overnight, more British evacuees arrived in the Maltese capital. Some came off the catamaran, the Maria Dolores, that had been at sea for over 48 hours. The authorities in New Zealand say up to a third of the buildings in the centre of